Hello everyone. I'll take the webinar on how to be a junior developer. And as most of us are here from second year, third year, or I'm guessing fourth year too. I don't know. But yeah, so we all come under the category of a junior developer. So basically, who's a junior developer? A junior developer is someone who has an experience of working which is less than 2 years, and we are the least in the food chain. Like we are the flowers, if I come to say. There's everyone above us, and we want to get to that level, and it can be very difficult, and it can be very confusing what to do. So this is my webinar. Won't be as long as long and as informative as Akash maybe, but yeah, I'll try my best. So first of all, and the first thing is that you should always read other people's code. There are people who are more experienced than you, and they have so Git is a very good place where you can start. Read other people's code so you understand it, how they write and how they name variables, what a clean code is. Also try to read official docs rather than Stack Overflow, because you'll see most senior developers go to official docs to understand the language and the situation better than finding a quick fix. Well, it's really good to reach out to a larger community and use example code and find solutions. That work is much more important, and to know why and how the work has been done and what you could have done to get to to that point. Also, one more thing we can do is to zoom out. Junior developers tend to have a smaller focus when working with a system. Ask questions like, is this code consistent with how things have been done elsewhere in the code base? Is the code reused elsewhere in the system? Will the code be easy to maintain in the future? As you work, zoom out and take a minute to figure out how your code fits in the bigger picture, basically. Always do your quality assurance. Most teams have automated and manual testing to ensure new features meet requirements and don't break existing functionality. But by doing rigorous testing on your own work before review, for example, in agile testing, if I guess most of the CSE students might have taken software development. So in agile testing, it happens so that once you push your code, a tester will check your code, and if there is any fault, it comes back to you and you have to correct it, and then it goes back, and it's kind of a loop. So if you test your code beforehand and on your own, then it you get better at producing quality work, and you have a better understanding of edge cases and test scenario, and it also saves times for the rest of the team, and you are always moving forward instead of backwards. You should never ignore the world around you. That means meetings, research, and time spent gathering broader context sometimes does feel boring, and you feel that I should be coding in that time instead of wasting it here. But as you may see, that understanding why we are doing something is more important than how we'll do it. See, if we add a functionality to a, say, app, I do app development. So if I add a functionality to an app of a business, it might not be useful for them if I don't if I haven't researched them properly. So I might add something, but if it's never used, it is a wastage of code, wastage of memory and obviously my time. Tests are your safety nets and compass. So yeah, good tests are safety nets. Lets you know as soon as you have broken something. Testing at regular intervals always ensures that you don't have undesired outcomes. And it also gives you confidence to make changes. So testing is a very good habit and you should always do it at regular intervals. Separate your concerns. It doesn't matter if working with object-oriented programming or functional programming. A good separation of concerns is a sign of a very skilled programmer. Now, you might have a question what concerns are. So areas of responsibility in the code, areas of focus in the code, and particular job the code is doing is what a concern is. And how one can identify his concern is by using the word and. For example, conference class is responsible for scheduling the conference and displaying the conference. So basically there are two methods, schedule conference and display conference. So that and word helped you out with figuring that out. Write short methods. So basically, when you're writing very long methods, it can get very confusing. And in the long run, when you have to modify the code or push an update, you will have to deal with a lot of code at the very same time. So a trick to write short methods is like, first you start off with a long method and break it into private methods that perform a step. And while you do so, document it. Documentation is the key, because otherwise later on when you read the code, when you are reviewing it, you might not understand what's going on. One more thing as a junior developer one should do is always seek constructive criticism. I get it that being praised on is very inviting and everyone likes it, but having constructive criticism is way more important to know where you are lacking and how you can improve. The best way to get constructive criticism is by asking for it. There was a quote I read somewhere that if you take pride in your code, it shows. And when you read it, it shows when you read it. And if you don't take pride in your code, then also it shows. The people who recognize your pride are the ones you want to work with. So those are the people you would really want to take your construct criticism from. Find a mentor. So this is very important. We are building on a work that started decades ago, and those that came before us, even by a few years, have a wealth of knowledge we can benefit from. You'll always be responsible for doing the groundwork, but you should have someone who can have some objective oversight on what you're doing and where you're going. If you want to make sure you don't deviate from your goals. I had the opportunity to have Alan Bhaiya as my mentor, and I thought that I had a lot of knowledge. I knew what I was doing, but to be honest, kuch nahi aata tha mere ko. When I started out, mujhe literally basics bhi mere clear nahi the. But by the guidance of Alan Bhaiya, I really got to a very straight path. So having a mentor is always helpful. Someone who actually takes you under your wing and wants to see you improve. It is very important, very, very important that you're familiar with your IDE and its shortcuts. So like for a blacksmith, a hammer is a tool. Your ID is a very essential tool for you. If you are comfortable and quick with your tool, you'll work faster, smarter, and other developers would enjoy working with you. And you might have seen when you're pair programming and the other person is very slow. I am a very slow typer, and it kind of gets very frustrating for the other person. And you want to be like, leave it, I'll do the coding. You give me the algorithm. Sometimes that's the case. So it's very frustrating when you're slow, and you should be comfortable with your IDE and all the shortcuts. Also, the newer IDEs like the IntelliJ IDE, which works on older scripts like Java, they often give you suggestions as to if there is a method that's not being called or the method redundant data. So you should always listen to their suggestions and remove the redundancy or not so useful code. Pair program with experienced developers. So while working with experienced developers, it can be very overwhelming sometimes because they know what they're doing. They're faster with it. They're quicker. They know the code. They know how to work with it. And they are very familiar with the IDE. And they pop out algorithms like it's a piece of cake. But then again, when you're working with them, you will learn a lot how some shortcuts you don't know or how some algorithms work. And if you, as I said, if you keep asking questions and always trying to learn, you will understand, you will have a better understanding because that will be practical understanding, practical knowledge you will be gaining, not something you'll read and then try to implement. So, as I said before, listen and respect both your senior developers, obviously, and also you should always respect your junior developers too, because knowledge can come from anywhere. And in this tech field, I feel the more the junior developer, there are chances he might know more because he has been, because tech industry is something that is always evolving and always growing. So there, I'm pretty sure there will always be something your junior developer, a person who's junior to you, might know which you might not. So you should always respect and listen to your juniors as well. You should always use good method or variable names instead of comments. So that's the thing. I know people would be saying that comments are very important and comments should be used. True, but good comments explain why and not what the code is doing. And a well-named method or variable beats a well-written comment any day. Because why do we put comments? So that the reader can understand the code. But if the variable or the method name is self-explanatory, you wouldn't need to put a comment. You should always expose your ignorance. We are in a learning field. Tech industry, as I said before, is growing, and you'll always have something to learn. And if you're shy and that people will ridicule me or people will not make fun of me and my seniors will think that I don't know anything, then that is not the case. We are here to gain knowledge. And if you ask questions and clarify and verify your doubts, at the end of the day, you are more knowledgeable. And if you pretend to know something, you are at zero because there's nothing new that you know. As a junior developer, it is very important that you have side projects. In order to keep growing, you can't rely mainly on your job because your company and its clients and its customers are both, all of them are looking for their priorities, and so should you. Build something fun and share your skills with a larger audience on Git. So as I said before, you can get constructive criticism and you can see where you stand, and you as a unique person will gain something, and your skills will improve if you have side projects of your own and not the only ones that your company is giving you. Also, patience is the key. So many people are junior developers even for 4 years or 5 years. But if you're not patient and if you don't understand that you have, the growth comes in, until and unless you haven't grown as a developer, you can't be promoted. So just hang in there and don't give up. One more thing is, as junior developers, we don't know, but senior developers are very familiar with, is that there is a library for everything. Like, you name it and there's a library for that damn thing. So GitHub, Stack Overflow are great places to find libraries. You want a library for UI, you want a library for ML, you name it and there will be a library for it. So search up libraries and you wouldn't have to write very long codes. Your library will do that job for you. Write clean code, which obviously a clean code will have a better understanding, and so future updates, everything, it becomes very easier to work with a clean code. You have a better understanding, you know what variable does what. So even while coding, you can get back to it. Testing is easier. And obviously updates are very, very smoother and faster. You should, and before starting out, you should always plan out what you're going to do. Nose diving into the situation is not always a very good idea, because you should get the broader perspective, why you're doing it, how you're doing it, what methods you will be using. So our OOPS teacher, which told us to write the pseudocode, well, we should write it. You should not avoid writing pseudocode thinking that I'm a very good coder. If you see the people at the very senior level coding, they always write a pseudocode so that they have a broader understanding. And lastly, I would like to tell you that you should always keep exploring for tech, because you don't grow old in this field when you age. You grow old when you stop learning. And there will always be something new in this industry. Like 5 years ago, who would have thought that 100 GB of data would be for what? $4.99. So, yeah, always keep exploring. Thank you. Any questions, anything?